हेलो एवरीवन, वंस अगेन आई वेलकम टू ऑल इन द न्यू सेशन ऑफ आवर क्लास। माय नेम इज राठौड़ खुशबू फ्रॉम परम गुरु पाठशाला संकुल सहरसा। डियर चिल्ड्रन, टुडे इन दिस सेशन आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अवर न्यू पोएम द काइट ऑफ क्लास 6 इंग्लिश सब्जेक्ट यूनिट 2 पार्ट 2. So dear children, the kite poem that is taken from Honeysuckle book. This is the second part of unit 2. The first part of unit 2, that was the lesson how the dog found a new master. So that was our first lesson that you have already get it. And if you have not seen, you can check our YouTube channel Param Guru Pathshala Sankul. You will get it in that link. So, The Kite, it is a poem that was composed by Harry Benn. So, the name of the poet is Harry Benn. Harry Benn, he described about the kite in this poem. Children, don't you feel the title itself? It's very interesting. You all have might tried to fly kites. So, in this poem, the poet himself, he described about kite. So, that we have to see in this poem. So, let's move further. Before moving our explanation of the poem, let me discuss some hard words related to this poem. So the first one is dive. Dive means to go into water with force and softness. So it is very simple that dive. You have might heard this word before earlier. So dive. Dive means to go into water with force and softness. Second one is snaps, that means cracking sound. So when you are flying a kite in the sky, so sometime you will get a cracking sound of that kite. So that is called snaps. Soars, that means fly high. When you fly your kite very high, so that is called soars. Sail means float. Tides means rising and falling waves. Crest, that means top of something. String, that means thread. Slack, that means loose. Ragged means torn or tattered. So, dear children, these are the hard words that you will get it in your poem. So, read it well and prepare it. Now, let's move our explanation of this poem without wasting time. The kite. All of us like to fly kites. Have you ever tried to fly one? Read this poem about a kite as it flies in the sky. Everyone they have tried to fly the kites in the sky, but someone they know it very well and someone maybe they don't know how to fly the kites, but in their life at least one time they have tried to fly the kites. So that written in this first line, that all of us they have tried to fly kites. And have you ever tried to fly one? So read this poem about a kite as it is flies in the sky. How bright on the blue is it a kite when it's new? With a dive and a dip, it snaps its tail. So in this four line, let's come to the explanation. The poet says that when a sky is clear and there are no clouds. It looks a blue sky. So it is very interesting to see a new and colorful and attractive kite in the sky. The kite moves with a gently or softness or force at the same time. You can see here. See how beautiful the kite looks here in the blue sky. Okay, so the poet says that it is very beautiful to see the kite flying in the blue without any cloud in the sky. So the kite moves with gently or softness and force at the same time. The poet also explained that when the sky its tail flutter and creates a cracking sound in the air. So you can see here in the picture how the tail of the kite that is fluttering in the sky. So the poet compared the sound of fluttering, that is a cracking sound. Understand? So here it is very beautifully described about the kite, that it looks very beautiful, colorful, a new kite that fly in a clear sky, in the blue sky. So it is very interesting to see. The poet feels so joyful to see this kind of kite in the sky. Then soars like a sea with only a sail, as over tides of wind it rides, climbs to the crest of a gusts and pulls, then seems to rest as wind falls. Here the poet has compared the kite with the sea. You can see here the picture of sea. So how the sea moves in the sea, that you can see. So the poet compared here the kite with the sea. The movement when the kite flies, it's up and down in the sky, it looks like a sea. Such moves help it to float in the sky. Just the waves rising and falling in the sea. So with the sudden blow of strong wind, it goes up to the highest point in the sky. So in a wavy manner, the way a ship moves on the sea, but as soon as the wind slows down, it seems as it has stopped there to take some rest. So here the poet very beautifully described that he compared the kite with the ship, that how the ship moves very gently on the sea, okay, rising and falling. That means as the sea waves come, jaise samandar mein aise waves aate hai, and the sea, the movement of the sea, that you can see it. So the same way when the wind blows in the sky, just like the kite goes up and down. That means he compared the rising and falling of that kite. When string goes slack, you win its back and run until a new breeze blows and its wings fill and up it goes. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's anew? So the poet says that when the thread, that means like this, it is called a kite thread. So the thread tied to the kite, that is loosen the flyer, runs and rolls it back. See, okay, so when the thread, when the person who is flying a kite, so the thread tied to the kite, it loosen the flyer, runs and rolls it back. It waits till a new fresh air blows again and fills it wings with air again to help it to fly high. Dear children, that means that whenever we are flying a kite. Okay, so all the time the winds are not blowing at the same manner. Sometime that is a strong wind and sometime the winds goes down. So at that time what happened? Our kite, that is illusion, that means for who is flying the kite, that person can feel that now there is a no strong wind, so the kite become looser. Understand? And once again when the wind blow gently or maybe strong, so at that time we feel that yes, now abhi jo hawa aa rahi hai to वो जो मूवमेंट ऑफ द काइट है वो अपने आप ऐसे स्ट्रांग हो जाती है. सो तो द विंग विद एयर अगेन टू हेल्प इट टू फ्लाई हाई. तो उस टाइम पे जो काइट है वो बहुत ही हाई हम फ्लाई कर सकते हैं. अगेन द पोएट रिपीटेड द लाइन ही सेज दैट इट दिस न्यू काइट अगेन फ्लाई इन द स्काई इट लुक्स वेरी ब्यूटिफुल एंड अट्रैक्टिव विथ ब्राइट color. But a raggeder thing you never will see when it flaps on a string in the top of a tree. So dear children, here the poet says that the kite looks bright and very attractive when it is flying in the sky. But when it gets stuck on a tree, you can see here in this picture. See, the second one is also. So, when it gets stuck on a tree top, it gets torn and gives a bad worn out look that is not liked by everyone. So, here the poet wants to say that the kite is very beautiful when it flies in the blue sky. But if it is in the state of it, that means stuck on a tree, it is not liked by everyone. So the beauty of the sky is only the movement of the kite in the sky. So dear children, here the poet says that it is very beautiful to see the kite in the sky when the kite was new, but when it gets stuck on the tree, it is not liked by everyone. So, dear children, you have seen that the poet is praising the beauty of kite when only it is flying in the sky. But if it is in the state of waste, it is not liked by everyone. So, I hope this poem is clear to you and enjoyed it well. So let's move towards our exercise that is given in poem. Working with the poem, so the first one is list out the action words in the poem. Dear children, you have seen our poem and in that poem there are given some action words like dive, deep, snaps. Understood? So which are some action word more in this poem that you have to find out and write in these blanks. Okay, so five more action words that are given that you have to find out it yourself, and even you have to write the meaning of that action words also. Okay, so dear children, this exercise you have to write it in your notebook. Once again I am telling you, write down, find out the action words that are given in the poem that you have already get it in the previous slides. Okay, so you have to just read it and find out action words and write the meaning of that words too. So the second exercise is read these lines from the poem. Then soars like a sheep with only a sail. The movement of the tailless kite is compared to a sheep with a sail. This is called a simile. Can you suggest what or who the following actions may be compared to? Dear children, Simile, that is a one kind of figure of speech that you can use in the poems. Understand? So simile, that is one kind of figure of speech. So here two lines are given, and as you know it well, that the poet compared kite with the sheep. So same here, that is called the poet used simile here. So some more actions that are given below, and you have to compare with that actions. You have to write it yourself. But let me give one example. He runs like blank. So here you have to use one kind of simile, like he runs like cheetah. Understand? So here the action of running, that is compared with the running with cheetah's running. Understand? That means similar. So that is called simile. The second one, he eats like, she sings like, it shines like, it flies like. So the rest of others, you have to write it yourself. Is it clear? So I hope you are able to write this exercise yourself. Write it in your notebook. So dear children, I hope you understand this lesson, our poem, The Kite, well. You can listen it twice and understand better. Thank you for watching this video.